Pitching defined Barry Zito. And by the time he was amongst baseball's elite as a Cy Young Award winner, he was quick to credit his work ethic and perseverance. In fact, to suggest his rise to the top was anything other than his own determination was an insult.
I remember one time in 2003, I was in the Ritz-Carlton in Philadelphia, and it was after a game, and a woman came up to me, and she said, "Wow, you have such incredible pitching talent, this curveball you throw and all these things. I mean, you just really got blessed. You were so blessed with such talent." And I literally got upset with her, and I said, "Blessed?" I said, "Do you know how hard I've been working since I was 7? I've earned this."
Off the field, Barry enjoyed the spoils that came with worldly success. It completed his identity as baseball star and Hollywood playboy.
I identified with success in nightlife or in that Hollywood scene as a part of my identification of self, my value as a person. And it almost became an extension of success on the field.
But in 2007, when Barry achieved the most lucrative contract for a pitcher in baseball history at the time, he didn't plan on his career taking a downswing. His mounting losses weren't meeting expectations, and fans turned on him.
I couldn't sleep at night. I would be like up in the middle of the night, like Googling like things like self-confidence. Like, how do I feel that? 2008 was kind of the worst of all that. I started out 0-8 with like, I got taken out of the rotation. The newspapers, the TV people were saying like terrible things. I remember I would go into restaurants at night and fans would be on the other side of the bar and they'd be yelling expletives like with my name. I took it very hard, and those were some like really dark years.
Unfortunately, bigger disappointments were to come. When the Giants advanced to the World Series in 2010, Barry was left off the postseason roster because of his unreliability on the mound.
So I watched the team that I was essentially brought over to help win a World Series. I watched them win it, and I couldn't participate, and it was like the heaviest thing I'd ever been through in my life.
Barry was becoming distant and detached. His girlfriend Amber had a front row seat to his struggle.
2010 was a really dark year for him, and I feel like there were days when I would look into his eyes and be like, "Are you in there?"
Barry tried to clear his head, but the following year brought even more challenges. A car accident and a quirky foot injury that sidelined him for 3 months. Barry was anxious, afraid, and desperate to make sense of it all.
And I had all these books. My bookshelf at the time was probably the entire Barnes & Noble self-help catalog.
I think you can tell a lot about a person from their library. And the more I spent time with him, the more I realized, like, what's going on here?
And I was reading different books, and I was with Amber, and she just said, "Honey,
you're searching for something, and I promise you, you will not find it in these books." I'm like, "I would like to offer you one book." And I'm like, "And I promise you, you're gonna get an answer."
I had started to read the Bible consistently, and we just started reading Proverbs every night.
Barry was done seeking answers from within himself. Being defined by accomplishments had backfired. Desperate for a new identity, Barry went to talk to the team chaplain.
"I need help, man. I cannot do this. I've gone to therapists. I've read self-help books. I've relied on my own strength as much as I can. I've exhausted all of my possibilities." And I said, "I think I'm ready to, you know, to trust someone else, something else beside what I can muster."
Barry prayed to give his life to Jesus.
In my coming to Jesus moment, I had, you know, really amazing kind of feelings inside, like I had this new identity, and I knew Jesus was on my shoulder saying, "Hey, I'm the guy."
In 2012, Barry returned with flashes of brilliance that helped lead the Giants to another World Series championship. This time, with Barry at the helm and God in his heart.
I think the last 2 months of the season, I was getting on a roll. And I had some great games in the playoffs and got to contribute in the World Series and pitched game one of the World Series and won that game. And the entire experience was about God. It was not about me.
As Barry retires from his baseball career, he's found peace and purpose in life. Now married to Amber, they're enjoying parenthood for the first time, never losing sight of the new life they have discovered in Christ.
there are times when I can feel alone, even now, and I realize it's because I get caught up in my own neuroses of my humanness. And when I step back and say, hold on, I'm not alone at all. I'm a whole, complete person because my life is in Jesus Christ.